Repairing a DC to AC power inverter. Here we have my 300 watt 12 volt DC to 120 volt AC SamlexPower inverter, which failed outside of the warranty, so I decided to try and fix it. You may get lucky and only need to replace a blade fuse on a faulty power inverter, but sadly that is rarely the case. Here you can see a 40 amp blade fuse on the circuit board, and as predicted, it's like new. The most common components to fail on a power inverter circuit are the Mosfet transistors, which generally burn out before the fuses blow, so that's where I will start my testing. I disassemble the case, remove the heatsink clamps, and slide out the main circuit board. Mosfets come in a variety of packages. This board has two banks of four TO220 packaged Mosfets, and they should look something like this. I wrote down their identities and searched for them online to confirm they were definitely Mosfets. The three pinouts on this MOSFET are the gate, drain and source. The middle drain pin connects to the heatsink on top. I wanted to test the MOSFETs without removing them from the circuit board. To do this, you will need a multimeter with a diode testing mode. Place the positive probe on the gate pin, which is the first pin on the left looking from the front, or in my case, the third pin on the right looking from the rear. Place the negative probe on top of the heatsink, which connects to the drain pin. You should get a reading of 1 to 2 volts. As you can see, the first two MOSFETs I tested give virtually no reading, so they are dead. And the next two look fine, around 1.5 volts. I swing the board around and test the second set of MOSFETs, and they all give a good reading. MOSFET banks should really be replaced altogether, so I went ahead and removed the two bad ones and the two good ones. I am using copper solder wick to remove the majority of the solder, then I wiggle out the MOSFET pins with some thin nose pliers while still heating the solder pads. You should use a decent soldering iron with 60 plus watts or a soldering station when removing MOSFETs. It is possible to do this with a cheap 35 watt iron, but you will have your work cut out. I called around some local electronic component stores, but no one had the MOSFETs I required. But one shop did have some equivalent ones with slightly better specifications. Now to solder the new MOSFETs in place. This circuit board is double-sided and the MOSFETs need to be soldered on both sides. As you can see, my soldering quality with this iron isn't too pretty. Unfortunately, my main iron recently broke and I am waiting delivery of the new one. Now to reassemble everything. Make sure to put some new thermal paste between the thermal pad and the MOSFETs, and on the opposite side between the thermal pad and the main heatsink. Sorry, but I forgot to record this part. Now for a quick test, and the power inverter stays green and no longer goes to the abnormal amber mode. The multimeter reading with no load looks good at 120.5 AC volts. Now to test the inverter with a small load. I first connect a ground fault circuit interrupter for extra safety. Now I connect a low wattage device and it works fine. The power inverter cost me around $160 5 years ago, and the four MOSFETs to fix it came to just under $10, so I'm very happy the inverter has a second life. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.